Hello everyone, welcome to another brand new video of GitLab series. In this video, we will write the Dockerfile and build an image from the Dockerfile and push that image to GitLab Container Registry. So at the end of this lesson, we will learn the followings: how to write a Dockerfile, how to build an image from the Dockerfile, how to publish that image to GitLab Container Registry. So without further ado, let's get started with Hanson. So first of all, create a Dockerfile at the root level of your project. So from, we need to mention the base image. After colon, we need to mention the tag. So in this case, we are saying Ubuntu 16.04, which means pull the Ubuntu 16.04 Docker image from Docker Hub Container Registry. Then we have label. Label is not a mandatory step here, but if you want to have some metadata in your Docker image, you could add label. So in our case, we have label. We are labeling version 1.0.0. In line 7, we have arg, which is short for arguments. So arg debian underscore front end equal non-interactive to turn off question asked for location and time zone. Run step does three things: update the Ubuntu package repositories and install Apache Nano and Apache 2 utils packages. And lastly, it does clean up the leftovers from /var/cache folders. So let's write a simple HTML file for index.html. So open up the HTML tag, the opening tag and closing tag. And inside it, we're gonna have body tag. And inside that, we want to have a header tag h2 to show some content in it. So in our case, we're gonna use our demo page. So the idea of creating the index.html file is to replace the default web page content of Apache web server when you browse it after you install it for the first time. All right, now our index.html file is ready in our host machine. So we are gonna copy index.html file from our host machine to container. So we need copy command, and copy command first argument is going to be source and then the target. So our source is going to be index.html and target is going to be /var/www/html within the container. So if we run the command 3, you can see this is within our project. So index.html is in our current directory. Oops, while recording the video, I have forgotten to put the extension index.html. So far in our Dockerfile, we have installed Apache web server. We have copied index.html from host machine to container. So we need to expose our service, which is Apache web server, on port 80 so that we can access using a browser from our local machine, which is host machine, or from within the container. So what have we done so far is that we have exposed our services on port 80. We have copied index.html to the container, but we have not started our service, which is Apache. So as soon as the container is ready, we need to run our service. So therefore, we need to run cmd command. Cmd command is responsible to run some services on the background or in the foreground. So let's run this command to run Apache web server. So which is cmd apache ctl the flag d, which is minus d. You could have also run cmd service apache 2 start or systemctl apache 2 start, but in our case we are just going with this command. So our Dockerfile creation is done, so we're gonna test it soon. Don't worry if you cannot follow along the video, just pause it and re-watch it again. Let's go to the terminal and we're gonna type in docker build --help. I just wanted to show you how you could do it by yourself without struggling too much. using the CLI command of Docker. If you forget what options are available with Docker build, you can always go back to Docker build --help command and you can check out all the options. So Docker build -t, t means tag. So we want to tag our image with Apache _ web server. F means the location of your Dockerfile. So location of our Dockerfile in the current directory. Oops. So as you can see the error /index not found. So index was missing the .html extension. So let's run it again. If everything is okay, it should pass through. So let's see. Well, we have one more error. So the error actually was about do you want to continue? So in this case, we did not pass in the -y flag. Well, now you have got a good debugging session as well. So if everything goes through, the Dockerfile should not throw up any more error. Let's wait and see what happens. Let me pause the video for now and we'll come back once it's ready. Alright, I'm back and our image is built and it has taken roughly 31.3 seconds to build the entire image. Depending on the run commands and the amount of package to be installed within the image, it might take quite a lot of time. So now we have built our image, which is Apache _ web server. And to see the images, you can run the command docker images. So that will list all the images that you have in the local machine. So docker images command will show you the repository, which is Apache _ web server, also the image ID and when this image is created and the size of the image. So now we have built our image and we want to run the container with that image. So to run that container, we have to run docker run command and it takes a couple of options. -d means detach, -p means the first ad means on the host side, which is your local machine, and second part after colon ad means on the container side. So on the container side is gonna expose port 80, on the host machine is gonna expose port 80 as well. And Apache web server, which is the image name, or you can pass in the image ID. So if you run docker ps command, it will show all the running containers. So as you can see, Apache web server container is running. Docker ps command output a lot of information about the container. That includes container ID, image name, what command actually was running, and then at what time the container is created, the status of the container and the ports. So now we have our container running. So we want to get inside the container. So to do that, we need to run docker exec command, which takes a couple of options, but in our case, we need to pass in -int, which is interactive, tty terminal, and then the container ID or container name, and then we want to run the bash shell within the container. So once we get into the container, as you can see, we run service apache2 status command, and we can see apache2 is running. And now we want to run the curl command on port 80 on our local host. That will show our demo page. Wow. So we can see our web page is running. So this is the page we have written before, if you remember, index.html file. So far we have been able to see the page within the container, but we want to see it also from our local machine. So to do that, you need to open up a browser and type in localhost. So far we have built our image out of the Docker file, and then we have run the container and we have verified the content of the web page, which is our demo page. So seems like everything is working and we are happy. So at this point, what we want to do is that we want to tag our Docker image. So let's run docker tag --help command to see a bit more about the use case of this command. So docker tag, we're gonna run in docker tag command, which takes the source image ID. So in our case, source image ID is Apache web server ID, so 208, blah, blah, and then the registry. So registry is the target image. So we have tagged our image, so you can run the command docker images and you can see your image here, so which is Apache underscore web server. So we have tagged our image, so before we push our image to GitLab Container Registry, we need to log in to the private registry. So the address is, in our case, registry.github.com. So then we need to pass in the username, which is -u. Once you enter, it will ask for the password. So if you pass in the password, it should show you on the console login succeeded. So let me grab the commands that we have run so far and paste it to our readme.md file as a reference so that I can paste them in the video description. Let's copy this to our clipboard and then run the command docker commit. Docker commit itself is not a mandatory command that you should run. As you can see, docker commit takes some options. One of them is message, which is -m, and after that we need to pass in the container. So to pass in the container, we need to run docker ps command that gives the container ID, so you can grab that container ID. So docker commit -m, so we pass in a message called Apache web server, and then we pass in the container ID. And the last option is the repository tag that we have already copied before, so now we paste it. So we have added a message, so now we want to push. So to push the image, we need to run docker push and then paste in the repository tag so that we have copied before. So now we are pushing the image to GitLab private registry, and our image size was 265 megabytes. Our image size was 265 megabytes, so it should not take too long time, to be honest, and my network connection is pretty good, so I'm expecting to take like 1 or 2 minutes. Yeah, let's open up a browser and go to your container registry homepage. So you can see the Apache web server repository is created, but so far no tags available there. It's because the docker push command didn't push the image yet. So docker push might take some time depending on the speed of your network and also the size of the image. In our case, we had only 265 megabytes of image, so it should not take too much time. So let's refresh the page and you should be able to see one tag. Right now we have 0 tags, so it means that the image is not pushed yet. All right, so now we have our image pushed to our remote repository. So let's write the command as well as a reference for documentation. Yeah, so I have included all the commands in the readme.md file that I'm gonna also put as a part of the description of this video. Thanks for watching my video and stay tuned for the next one.